This Group B preliminary round match features Canada against their Norseca Zone rivals, Puerto Rico. Canadian coach Glenn Hogue is treating these Pan Am games as a preview of what the team will have to face if they make it to Rio or the Olympic Games. Puerto Rico ranked 23rd in the world, but they're coming off a confidence-boosting win over the United States 2 days ago. Watch for number 8, Stephen Morales, who is their big jumper. He was unstoppable for Puerto Rico. As you take a look at the standings right now, the Canadians are on top on the strength of a 3-0 win over Mexico in the first round, followed by Puerto Rico. Got 4 points because it was a 3-1 victory over the United States. And as we get set for this match, we will start by meeting the officials who will be in charge of the protocol. The up referee will be Gerardo Morel. He is from Cuba. And the down referee is Paul Albright. He is from the United States, will be watching for net touch violations and will be interacting with the scorer's table to keep everything on track. And now we will have a chance to meet the starting lineups for both teams. Beginning with Puerto Rico. Gaspar appointed as the head coach of this Puerto Rican squad in May 2015, so not a long time with the team, but he has them playing well, as we witnessed against the United States in a 3-1 win. And now it's time to meet the Canadians. Number 3 played in the Pan Am Games in beach volleyball back the last time Canada hosted in Winnipeg, and here he is at the age of 39 participating again as the libero indoors as coach Glenn Hogue looks on. An Olympian, played with the national team of Canada from 81 to 86, participating in the 84 Olympic Games, and has transferred that knowledge now into coaching, passing it on to a team that has been on the rise, qualified for the World Cup last month in Detroit City, and finished 7th in the World Championships last year in Poland.
Number 1, Tyler Sanders.
The Canadians will be on the line for the first serve, and this is TJ Sanders. And right away, it's Morales out of the back row, and he was a machine for Puerto Rico, jumping so high, he was over the top of the blocks. It will be interesting to see if the Canadians can corral him as this match unfolds. And this one is hit out of bounds by Gord Perrin. So Puerto Rico jumps out to a 2-0 lead early in set one of this best of five match. Angle, no chance for Hector Soto on that play. Watch for Schmidt to get big volume as this match unfolds. He's 6'10", jumps out of the gym. 3.72 meters is his touch. And a miscue, but it's saved. No, it is out of bounds. And back and forth it went there on the Puerto Rican side. This is Juan Goas from San Juan, Puerto Rico. It's a good serve, and it's a violation called by Morel from Cuba, saying that the Puerto Ricans interrupted the opportunity of the Canadian setter, TJ Sanders, to set that ball up. So half of Puerto Rico's points early on here coming on missed serves by the Canadians. It is rally point. You miss a serve, you give a point to your opponent. And Schmidt, that is a mismatch on that side as Rivera is there. He's 1.86 meters, just over 6 feet. And he is blocking against the 6'10" Gavin Schmidt. So the Canadians will look to exploit that. And an over bump is put away by Vigras. And Puerto Ricans are asking for a net touch there. Couldn't see it. And neither could Morel. Well, errors is going to be a problem that Puerto Rico is going to have to look out for. They are going to be mindful of these tall Canadian blockers. And that one goes out of bounds, and Canada is up by two, so the Puerto Ricans call a timeout. Early action in set one of pool play. Men's indoor volleyball, Canada versus Puerto Rico. Canadians are up by two and a rocket from Gavin Schmidt. That cannot be saved. And what a serve. Schmidt was the best server in the finals for his club team Arcus in Turkey when they won the league championship. Also named the MVP of that tournament. And another one hits the floor. Two in a row for the big man. And at the technical timeout, the Canadians have doubled the score of Puerto Rico. It is 8-4 in set number one. This is Pool B preliminary play in men's indoor volleyball, Canada versus Puerto Rico. The Canadians serving strong are up 8-4, and it's another big one. Opportunity for Canada, and they come out of the pipe, and that one is down sharply. And Puerto Rico struggling to receive this serve. It has velocity, it has location. And this one finally is long, so they get a breather. Puerto Ricans are in transition, but this one is called a violation. And that was Jackson Rivera. He's a small outside hitter, and when he is facing the big block, it's going to be in his head a little bit. He commits an early error. And Schmidt is high off the block, and it sails well over the defense. No chance for them at all. And you can see Rivera is trying to get his hands up, but just doesn't touch high enough. But the Canadians give it straight back. Substitution, a double substitution now coming for Puerto Rico. Coming out is number two, Goas, and in for him is Cruz, 10. And that is Morales coming out, and number six, Angel Perez, moving in. He will be the setter. So Puerto Rico wanting three front row players, setter in the back row. The dig is made, but it cannot be tracked down. Gord Perrin just too strong on the wing. And the first block opportunity goes off Adam Simak. It was very close to the sideline. The referee signaling it was out. Puerto Rico is going to have to do more of that. If they go to the wings, the Canadian block is going to be too strong. We'll watch for that as this match unfolds. Here's a chance. And a net touch is called on Hector Soto. And again, he was turning to come off the net. And if you're in the act of playing the ball or getting away from the ball, you see how he turns to come back. Now he wants to come out to hit that ball, but he brushes the tape. Free ball. Here come the Canadians. Again, it is off the block. So the block's getting a piece of it, but there's so much force on that hit that it goes right over the head of the defenders. It shows you the power of this Canadian squad. Currently ranked number 14 in the world. So both times that Puerto Rico has gone to the middle, they have enjoyed success as Cruz comes back out. So that is something that they are going to have to work on. And this one powered off the block. Hector Soto coming in, making high contact. So Puerto Rico now down by four. An errant pass from the Canadian. Schmidt has to take something off this one, and another chance to close the gap. And this one is hammered right over Nick Hogue and down the line by the high-flying Morales. And Morales again, but Adam Simak is there, and he had that one wrapped. Watch how his hands are going to penetrate, find that ball, fingers straight down, and the ball follows. And Schmidt helping out on the block by Grass. Schmidt right together. That is a big wall there. 6'8", 6'10". And that one is rejected. And at the technical timeout, it's the Canadians continuing to lead. The margin now 5 points.
Let's see if we can beat it. All right, everybody, volleyball fans, let's get it!
A packed house at the Exhibition Center enjoying this round-robin matchup between Canada and Puerto Rico. The Canadians have led from the start. It is a five-point margin here in set number one. And there's a beautiful pipe from Puerto Rico with Rivera, the second man in, using that second tempo beautifully. Schmidt takes something off this serve, and a crafty play from Rivera. He is a high flyer, small, but gets up in the air. Most importantly, though, he is a salesman. Sold that one to the block, and the defense wasn't able to react. Nick Hogue plays his professional volleyball in France. Missed his first serve. Takes something off this one. And Morales is dug. Canadians save it. He's going to have another chance. Rivera, his second attack. Oh, tracked down, and Morales flushes it. The ball is down. As Steven Morales got up on that one in perfect position. The Canadians tracking the ball down. Perrin, hard shot is dug. Morales, he is blocked. Graham Vigrass, tremendous footwork to get from the middle to the left side of the court to stop that man. Number 8 from Puerto Rico. Hands over, side by side, the Canadians. The Puerto Ricans playing some great defense there. And there is a touch off the Canadian block on this broken play. Canada too hungry. Gord Perrin high off the block. Puerto Ricans are going to have to move their defense back, as these Canadians are used to hitting against big blockers playing in professional leagues all over the world. Sanders. There's Morales, back row, and off the block and out of bounds. It's a three-man wall, but terrific hit. Thank you. Canadian libero Dan Lewis trying to bring that ball up. Couldn't quite get his arms parallel to the floor, drive it up. And it ricochets out of bounds on the strength of Morales. But Canada still maintaining a four-point gap here, 21-17. It's set one. And there is a big sting on that ball. Steven Morales, and that's a big block that he's up against. And he's right on top of that block. And TJ Sanders, the Canadian setter, continuing the mismatch. He's going to exploit that with Gavin Schmidt on that right side against the smaller Rivera. Schmidt used to hitting big volume. As Puerto Rico calls a timeout, they trail by 5. Canada 23, Puerto Rico 18. The teams are back on the court. Canada up 23-18 to Puerto Rico in set number one of pool play action. Gavin Schmidt misses the handle on this one. He's scored two aces on his serve so far in this first set. Substitution for Puerto Rico. Ezequiel Sanchez coming in. Played his college ball in New England. Big serve handled easily. And this ball down by Vigras in the middle. And that brings Canada to set point number one. As the substitution is made again and Rivera is back in, Graham Vigras presenting the target for Sanders. The down referee checking the score. It's an electronic system used here at the Pan Am Games. Make sure you mention Peter Volleyball for It is 24-19. Canada up over Puerto Rico in set number one. Day two of men's indoor volleyball at the Pan Am Games in Toronto. And Nick Hogue spins that one into the net. But the Canadians have four set point opportunities here as Steven Morales is at the end line. It's a little dump, and that one is called a lift by the referee Morel. Does not like what TJ Sanders did there. And so Puerto Rico has eliminated one of those set points, so Canada will take a timeout. Canada has a set point against Puerto Rico in the opening set of this round robin pool play. Steven Morales on the end line for Puerto Rico. The spinner taken. What a dig. Puerto Rico keeps it alive. And there is a net touch on the Canadian side. So the Puerto Ricans refusing to roll over. And they close the gap 24-22 now as Canada makes a substitution. Captain Fred Winters will come in for Nick Hogue. And it's kept alive. No, it's waved down. A late call from Morel as the ball was still alive, or the Canadians thought it was. And Gavin Schmidt is blocked, and all of a sudden, this one is tight. The Canadians appeared to be totally in control and cruising to victory. But Puerto Rico has denied them that, and they have closed the gap now to a single point. The crowd is cheering on the Canadians as they have seen three set points eliminated by Puerto Rico. They have a fourth here, looking to close out this first set. And the tip off the block is kept alive. This one could tie it. Here come the Canadians, though, in transition. Gavin Schmidt, and he finally puts it away as Canada gets out of jail and wins set number one. Gavin Schmidt cruising in from the back row, goes outside the outside blocker, and puts that one to the floor. He is the leader of this squad on court. And the Canadians in the timeout. Glenn Hogue was talking about having attitude. You need it on every single point, but Canada escapes that one 25-23 over Puerto Rico. Fought hard right through to the end of that set. The Canadians seem to get the set point and want to put it in cruise control, and in the end had to push hard for the win. As you take a look at the statistics, not much between these two teams. Puerto Rico doing a better job in the digging area. The Canadians, 7 service errors. So that kept Puerto Rico in the set, particularly towards the end. And Coach Hogue will be looking for more from his athletes in set number 2. This is set 2 action between Canada and Puerto Rico in men's indoor volleyball. The Canadians were in control of set 1, but went to sleep towards the end as Puerto Rico caught up. Canada is up 1-0. The starters are back in. TJ Sanders, he will be doing the setting for this Canadian squad. 1m91, he's a 6'3" setter. Played a couple of years professionally in Europe. And it is Rivera who will start for Puerto Rico, Jackson Rivera. Hogue out of the back row. And the middle attack is hard. Adam Simak is there. The hand's a little late. And out it goes. 1-1. Set number 2. Gets 2 swings at it, buries the second one. It's the same shot, just a little bit more to the left side of Morales. No chance for him. Oh. And down the line goes Morales off Nick Hoag. He has been impressive in this tournament, this youngster, 23 years of age. And the blockers on the Puerto Rican side are inexperienced. So you can see how they have to go with the middle. It opens up a big seam, and that's where the Canadian attackers are placing the ball. Little roll shot, Lewis steps in. Schmidt, this one is tracked down. Transition for Puerto Rico, but the block is not good. I thought that was in, but it was wiped out of bounds by Rivera. And so Puerto Rico is in the lead now by 1 point. It is 4-3. And this one is off the block as Nick Hoag comes in. Hits that one hard. The Canadians passing the ball to Sanders very well. All the options available. Puerto Rico, though, digging hard. And again, it's the middle of Puerto Rico that is hurting the Canadians as they are on time and on point. And this one is on the line. What a bullet that was. Hoag did not even move. That one was down before he could blink. Watch this serve. It's like a laser beam right on the line. And Hoag hits this one hard. Not much of a takeoff, but he is strong. Canadians hitting hard, but the Puerto Ricans are digging. Here comes Canada again, a fourth chance to put it away, and finally Schmidt hammers it off the block. Time after time, Puerto Rico making digs. Canada having to work hard now for every point. This ball ricochets out of bounds, but the Canadians make the save. And it is down on the Canadian side. Morales seemed like he had to wait an eternity for that high ball, but then just thrashed it. And that brings us to the technical timeout where the Canadians are being outplayed right now. It is 8-6 Puerto Rico. Canada is trailing 6-8 right now to Puerto Rico, although they are up 1-0 in set number 2 of this best of 5 match. And this one is well long, so the Canadians get one back, looking to capitalize, get some momentum here, as Puerto Rico has been digging in, bringing everything up. And another error on the Canadian side as that ball goes into the tape from Graham Vigras. And Rivera will be back. He is a float server. The Canadians will be looking to get their hands on this one. And Gord Perrin goes off the outside block of Escalante. And again, the middle. One blocker, Adam Simak, not able to take the angle away. And Puerto Rico puts it to the floor. And so the woes continue for Canada as that one is long. That's 2 in a row. Puerto Rico not having to work for their points. The Canadians having to work for every single one. And this is going to be a free ball opportunity. Tight to the net. And it is good night. This one is hammered down. Mannix Romanov all over this one. The 32-year-old veteran gets up and it is down. So you have to get a block up to have any chance here. Thought there was going to be a timeout call, but the referee is waving it off. Not sure if somebody missed the timing on this, but He's calling the captains over. So this is a delay of game warning. You can see that yellow card up by the watch means a delay of game. The Canadians were too late calling that timeout. And so they are assessed a warning. The next one will result in a point. Puerto Rico is up by three now. But Canada gets it back. Beautiful save on that set from TJ Sanders. And Rudy Verhoef will come into the game now. Speedy middle for the Canadian squad. He takes out Graham Vigras. Canadians seem to be stuck in simple ignition here. Somebody needs to ignite them a little more. And this one is outside the block and down the line. So Puerto Rico very consistent here in set number two. Another big serve. Hogue trying to finish, got a half speed the ball. Transition, here comes Morales again. And it is off the block of Gavin Schmidt. Rivera gets up there fearlessly. Canadians now trailing by 4 points. Puerto Rico just doesn't let anything drop on their side. And they are rewarded. Verhoef up and down. Schmidt is on the service line now. He can get this team going. He has a big serve. It's a hard one. It's a free ball for the Canadians. Here they come in transition. Off the block, and that is a point. And there is the strength of the Canadian game, strong from the service line. So immediately Puerto Rico calls a timeout as they try to interrupt the flow of Schmidt. And want to talk this over, they still maintain a 2-point margin over the Canadians. This is set two of pool play action between Canada and Puerto Rico. The Canadians winning the first set. And Puerto Rico on top here in set two. Canada trying to come back into this as they are being outplayed right now, particularly on defense by this motivated squad from Puerto Rico. They beat the Americans the other night, 3-1. So they are a legitimate contender here. And an error as Verhoef puts this into the net on his own side. And at the technical timeout, the Canadians have fallen behind by 4 points. Have some ground to make up. Set two of men's volleyball. Pool play action, Canada, Puerto Rico. Canadians up 1-0, but trailing by 4. Lewis on the pass. Schmidt out of the back row. Nick Hogue has been spotty on his serve. Missed the last one. This was a good one. Canadians in transition. Schmidt has to take something off it. And that one is to the floor. So Canada makes up a couple of points, and it's a 2-point spread right now. This set's a little bit low for Schmidt. He has to make that adjustment. Morales, no respect for that block at all. He is so high, right over the top and down. Right back. So it's the two right sides banging balls out of the back row and the front row right now. Morales and Schmidt, a head-to-head battle. Tip, it's pancakes. The block is there, though. Morales from 4.5 meters back. But Canada recognized what was going on, and Perrin rejects the ball. And that ball down on the Puerto Rican side as we are getting closer here. Substitutions coming in for Puerto Rico. Cruz and Perez coming in. Morales out, along with Goas. So a little change in the flow now. New setter, new attacker on the left side for Puerto Rico. And it is up and down in the middle. That's a quick one. The first pass on that, and Simak draws the blocker. Perrin one-on-one, and he just hammers that one to the floor. This is the first set that the Canadians have been challenged in during the games so far, so this will be a test for them. It dribbles over and it's down. TJ Sanders scores on the sniveler. And that ties things at 18 here. Canadians trying to build a little momentum. Off the block and out of bounds. Gord Perrin was saying it hit the attacker Cruz there on the way out. I don't think so. No, directly out of bounds. So that point over to Puerto Rico. They are up now by a single point. It is 19-18. Schmidt hard off the block. Always want to go cross court when there's a middle player playing defense and left back. And that was Escalante who got burned on that. Perrin takes a lot off this one. And it's a pipe shot. Kept alive. Lewis to Hogue. Cruz. Lewis again. Perrin from the back row. Great save by the Canadians. It's inside the block and it scores. The Puerto Ricans are furious. Having words with Morel from Cuba. I'm not sure what that was about. Or if they thought it was a lift, but it looked clean. And Morel signaling the captain over. In volleyball, there's only one person allowed to talk to the referee, and that is the captain. They will not have it if anybody else comes over. And Gaspar wants to call a timeout right away. As you see, Soto is still furious. And at that timeout, the Canadians have taken a one-point lead after being down by four. It is 20-19. Set two has been a battle between Canada and Puerto Rico. And the Canadians are on top by a single point right now. As Cruz is looking for the touch, but he is not going to get it. Tries to go high off the Canadian block. So Canada now up by two. Scores the ace. It is a seam shot. A right into the deep corner. Take a look here at 16. He just turns and lets it go. Rivera, no help from his teammates there. And a substitution is made as Goas comes back in. And Cruz is out. Disappointed in himself. Hard serve this time. The little tip is down. So Puerto Rico gets one back. They're trailing by two, late stages of set two. Nick Hogue is protecting the line as Puerto Rico is serving down 2 points at the end of set two. Here come the Canadians. It's a roll shot. Morales off the block and out of bounds. Gets one back for Puerto Rico. The gap now a single point. Puerto Ricans fighting to stay alive. A loss here and they would go down 2-0. But a win and we are tied up as Canada calls a timeout. It is 22-21 for Canada in set number two over Puerto Rico in men's indoor volleyball round robin action. Back and forth this one has gone as Puerto Rico has really dug in. Nick Hogue explodes on that one though, and that'll give Canada a little padding on their lead as substitutions now are coming in. And this is Fred Winters coming in to serve, the captain of this squad from Victoria, British Columbia. Played his professional volleyball in Brazil this last season and won the championship. An opportunity here now to take Canada closer to the end. Hard serve. Winters tracks it down, it's tight, but right there, the ball is put away. Mannix Roman strong in the front row. Another substitution here as Sanchez is coming in, number 20. Coming out is Rivera. Puerto Rico wanting a bigger player on the left side against Gavin Schmidt. And Winters out, Simak back in. Puerto Rico on the serve now. This is their captain, Hector Soto. Hogue on the pass to Schmidt. It's kept alive. Another opportunity for the Canadians in the middle. This one is tracked down. No, it can't be saved. It's out of bounds. Rudy Verhoef puts that one away, and that takes Canada to 24. The speedy feet of Verhoef as Soto does everything he can, but it is not enough. And the Canadians, the big man is on the end line. Puts a hard one into the net. So Puerto Rico escapes one set point. 24-23 now. Mannix Roman spin serves. Here comes Canada in the middle, and it is Rudy Verhoef. The last two balls going to number five, Rudy Verhoef from Calgary, Alberta. The Trinity Western grad puts that one to the floor and gives Canada a 2-0 lead here in this pool action. And you can see there is no chance, this one too deep as Verhoef presents a great target. There goes crossbody. And that's all that the Canadians needed. But that was much too close for Glenn Hogue's comfort. But Canada prevails in the end, and they are up 2-0 here in Pool B round robin play. Get a chance to take a look at some of the statistics from that second set. The Canadians better offensively, and this is what you would expect from this team, but committing five service errors to only one for Puerto Rico. But the Puerto Ricans not able to put the ball by the big Canadian block. And that was the difference in the end. Canada able to secure transition opportunities. Puerto Rico, though, digging hard, but they trail 2-0. The team from Canada is up by 2 sets over a game team from Puerto Rico, and they have given the Canadians all they can handle, as the difference in each set has been the slimmest of margins, 2 points. We are in set number 3. This is best of 5 to 25 points. Rally point action. The Canadians looking for their second sweep, but having to battle now for every single point. Canada making a change in the setting position. It's Dustin Schneider now coming in. TJ Sanders will have a rest. For Puerto Rico, it is their same starting lineup. Schneider will put the ball into play. Number 9, 29 years of age, native of Brandon, Manitoba. And a beautiful dump executed there. That ball is just thrown down. Schmidt high off the hands, and there's no chance for Goas there. He's just trying to soft block that. When you go across, instead of wrapping your pits around that ball, you break your wrist and let the ball hit down, so your back row has an opportunity to make a recovery. Errant passing from the Canadians. Gavin Schmidt gets a reload, and he's gonna take another whack at this one. Here comes Puerto Rico, though, out of the pipe. And that's the diminutive Rivera puts that one to the floor. So right away, it is 3-1 Puerto Rico. We saw this in the second set. The Canadians had to play from behind. A hitting error from Hogue, no touch. Oh yes, a touch is called as it caught a fingertip there. So the Canadians catch a break. And it's that turn back again that is hurting the Canadians out of the middle. Crafty play from Mannix Roman. He's only 1.90 meters, this middle player. And lots of skill. Graham Vigras does it all for the Canadians there. Starts with a hand pass and finishes with a crush. And Gavin Schmidt continues to have his problems on the serve. Serving that ball long. When it's in, it's a rocket. Just like that. It's another pipe, and somehow this makes it over the net. Canadians lucky there as Gord Perrin was coming out of the back row. Seemed to catch the top of the tape, but it rolled onto the Puerto Rican side, and Canada now trails by a single point with Nick Hogue on the end line. And he rolls this one into the net. Hogue's had a few weeks off, been suffering from tendonitis in his knee. First match back in a while. Beautiful combination. Dustin Schneider finding Vigras behind his head. And another dump is thrown down. The Canadians not attentive to that. And Goas just grabs that ball and throws it right into the middle of the court. And this time it is Escalante out of the middle. So Puerto Rico has been very effective from their interior, not as much from the outside, but they are up by 2 over the Canadians now. It is 8-6 in pool 3. They trail by 2 sets. That's Javier Gaspar encouraging his troops. He played for Penn State University between 85 and 1988. Now at the helm of this Puerto Rican squad, was inducted into the Eastern Intercollegiate Volleyball Association Hall of Fame in 2015. So a great player in his day. As the teams are back on the court, Canada and Puerto Rico are in a battle here. The Canadians up 2-0, but trailing here. Schmidt is dug. Here's a chance for Soto. Schmidt again. A free ball. Morales. Back and forth it goes. And finally, some miscommunication between Soto and Roman there. And that ball ricochets out the back. But Canada having to work so hard. Here's the play right here. Neither player knows who's going to take it. And the decision made too late. And there's a handset violation called on Gord Perrin. The Canadians are very close to the 3-meter line on this float serve. They want to take it with their hands, but Perrin caught in no man's land there, in between a hand pass and a forearm pass. This one, though, he contacts easily, and Hogue buries it, and that was a missed assignment. Steven Morales was coming to the interior against the middle. See him there, and that ball is put all the way to the pin. Morales immediately puts his hands up, apologizes to his teammates as Hogue celebrates. Schmidt with three blockers. It's a reload situation. And a third one, but it can't be saved. There's four contacts called by the official. So Puerto Rico has opened up a 3-point lead. Canadians continue to exploit that right side mismatch. Schmidt and Rivera. Schmidt has been spotty with his serve. Takes something off this one. Hogue on transition. And this is long. So some good play by the Canadians on the court, but finished with an error. Big serve gives a free ball. Here comes Puerto Rico, and that pipe is deadly as Soto goes angle. And the Canadians have called a timeout. They are now behind by four. This was the same situation one set ago when they had the battle to come back. Puerto Rico fighting those to stay alive. They are playing tough. Canada and Puerto Rico playing in round robin action here. Canadians up 2-0, but Puerto Rico pouring it on now, up by 4 points. Good serve. Creates a transition opportunity for the Canadians. It's Schmidt, and again it is down that line. And there is nothing that Berrios can do. He's the libero for Puerto Rico. But that ball is past him before he can move. Nice passing there. Canada keeping it alive? No. Nope. It is called two contacts by the referee. Canada trailing by two as Graham Vigras goes back to serve. A rangy middle, a 24-year-old from Calgary, Alberta. And there is a tremendous play. Escalante, so much faith in his setter there. He commits to that and just buried that one. And Rivera handcuffs the Canadians. Nick Hogue expecting the spin serve. It turns out to be a float. And it is all good news right now for Puerto Rico as they maintain a 4-point lead over the Canadians in set number three. It is 16-12. The number 23 world ranked Puerto Ricans are giving Canada a battle here in set three. As Gord Parent is dug by Berrios. Nick Hogue comes out of the back row, another diving save. And there's Lewis on the ground. Great rally, the dump this time kept alive. Diving save. Canada is going to have a free ball. Perrin off the block and down. Tremendous action on both sides of the court. Canada still trailing by three. Dustin Schneider. High ball to Soto. Off the block and out of bounds. Again, it's off Schmidt's hands on the outside. Escalante has a tough spin serve, this 31-year-old. This time Verhoef is there. So back and forth we go here. Canadians trailing by three. They've made one up. And Perrin completely loses the handle on that one. And we're going to have a substitution on the Canadian side now, as Gord Perrin is going to come out and Fred Winters will come in. Perrin going to take a seat on the bench, have a chance just to collect himself. Float serve is handled easily. Hold off the block of Morales. So that substitution works for the Canadians as they get the ball back. This is Rudy Verhoef. CIS first team all-star in his university career. And the block gets a hand on it, but it's inside the net and Vigras can't bring it back. So Puerto Rico keep creeping closer to 20 here. But Kevin Schmidt murders that ball. Puerto Rico had made an adjustment, had moved Morales over, who's a bigger blocker against Schmidt, but it made no difference. And here is Tone Van Lenkveld coming in for the Canadians. A left side player, he's replacing Dustin Schneider. Setting duties will fall to Dan Lewis, the libero now, as the Canadians put a big block in. The serve is a good one, and Van Lenkveld immediately puts that one down, so his presence is felt. Watch him poach on this ball. And that forces Puerto Rico to take a timeout as the Canadians are creeping closer here. The gap now 2 points as Puerto Rico's up 19-17. Rico is up on the Canadians, but they are making a challenge right now in set number three on the strength of Gavin Schmidt serving. This one just clearing the tape. Escalante, a diving save by Lewis, but it's down on the ground. So Canada robbed there of an opportunity as the Canadians will complete the double sub. TJ Sanders coming in the back row. Van Lenkveld will stay in the front row. Had a great World League, he did. And this one is out fractionally. As now it is 20-18. The Canadians have to make it happen here. Nick Hogue at the end line. Nick Hogue at the end line. Canada down by two. 20-18 to Puerto Rico. And that serve right into the net makes the margin three. And Steven Morales is on the end line. A big jumper. He has a deadly spin serve. This one, though, handled easily. Set to Winters on the wing. A diving save. Canada has to give a free one over. And a naked pipe is put to the floor by Hector Soto. And Puerto Rico now up by four. See, there is no blocker there for Soto. As he puts it away, and the Canadians have to call a timeout. This Puerto Rican squad really digging in, showed their grit the other night against the United States, and showing the same kind of energy here against the Canadians. Gord Perrin coming back in for Team Canada, but they trail by four to Puerto Rico here in set number three. Canada is looking for the sweep to take the maximum points, but Puerto Rico doing everything they can to stay alive. The ball is dug, it's kept alive. Berrios, amazing dig. And Vigras commits an error on the second one. So Canada falls even further behind. Reaction dig from Berrios. And Canada's gonna try to bury it now. It's gonna be too sharp on the angle. And that scores a point for Puerto Rico, 23-18 here. But the Canadians get it back. But they are in a big hole here. Puerto Rico needing only two side outs here to take this set. Well, one is saved on a Morales hitting error. And immediately, Javier Gaspar calls a timeout. He wants to calm his troops down. We are in pool play action here. It is day number two of men's volleyball. Canada up against Puerto Rico. They took the first two sets. They were both close, but Puerto Rico is really fighting hard in set number three, trying to stay alive on top of the Canadians. Morales off the block and out of bounds. The Canadians are arguing, but the referee is not having any of it. This is Morel from Cuba, so this is a set point opportunity for Puerto Rico. See if we can see here what the argument is. Was the ball in or out? I think the Canadians think it touched his foot, but the referee says no. So Canada, it was at set point, but that one is saved. 21-24 now, set number three. The Canadians up 2-0, but Puerto Rico on the verge of winning this set. Schneider goes deep, but it's a perfect pass. Morales, and he puts this one down with authority. And that gives Puerto Rico the set. They stay alive in this best of five encounter, but the Canadians still have the edge. It is 2-1. And there are words exchanged as these teams are crossing the net. Here is Morales, he is flying. That one is put down hard. Well, this one is going to a fourth set as Puerto Rico battles back. Canada up 2-1. The statistics from this set favoring the Puerto Ricans, but only very, very slightly in the blocking category. Everything else dead even. But Morales at the end was a key factor, both from the service line and his back row and front row attacking right over top of the Canadians as the Puerto Ricans steal a set. This is set four in preliminary Pool B action at the Pan Am Games. Puerto Rico and Canada, and both captains are over with the referee right now. And there's that international language where he's saying, I am not gonna put up with anything between you. So the next one who says anything is gonna be carded. As there is some history and some blood between these two teams. They are Norseca rivals, play each other in the zone. Rivera floats serving into the net, so Canada has the first point. Well, the question is, does Puerto Rico have another set in them to take this 1-5? Sanders, it's to the wing, Here's the Canadians in transition. But Morales is just too good, as TJ Sanders got a hand on that but couldn't bring it back into court. Schmidt on his approach, or his attack rather, did not get an approach. So it is 1-1. Puerto Rican defense stellar. Once again, Escalante is there. Here's a chance, but the block closes the door on Hector Soto. Perrin drops a short one in. It is Morales again. Back and forth we go here. Morales, 27 attacks so far. On the Canadian side, Schmidt has had 31. So it is a battle between these two players. Look at that tremendous back set. A one-hander from TJ Sanders. This is very, very good. Everybody taken out of the play there. Very difficult to do. Well, that ball was way, way long out of the court. But the Puerto Rican libero, Greg Berrio, stuck a hand out. Had no chance to stop that one. And it ricochets deep. And so Puerto Rico wants to change the momentum. Schmidt on a bit of a roll here. Puerto Rico down by two. It's 5-3 Canada. Canadian coach Glenn Hogue staying with his starters in set number four against Puerto Rico. Canada up 2-1 and up 5-3 here in set number four. Schmidt with a big serve. The pipe is dug. But it goes under the net, is immediately gobbled up by Rivera and thrown back to his server. Hogue coming from the outside against the block. The digs there, Hogue again. This time it's a tip. And very, very close to being dug. These Puerto Ricans getting their hands on everything, but it falls on the ground. Take a look here. The dig made and Escalante just can't bring it back. Canada maintaining a 2-point lead. And Hogue's worries continue. as he puts it into the net, looking rusty. First tournament back after a break, nursing tendonitis in the knee. And that's a better set to Gavin Schmidt, nice and high. Make him extend for that ball. Schmidt touches 3 meters 72. That's 12'2½". So you put a ball up there and he will go get it for you. And a dump by TJ Sanders. The Canadians very lucky that this one didn't fall into court. Almost dug by Puerto Rico at the first technical timeout, though. The Canadians are on top. It's a 2-point lead, 8-6. Puerto Rico full of confidence after their win over the United States. They are down to the Canadians, but they have battled hard. This is set number 4. Gord Perrin pushes that ball right into the hands of Goas. A crafty play from the veteran. Canada now with a 3-point lead. Lewis trying to make the dig. It's tracked down. Sky ball over. Here come the Puerto Ricans. And look at that shot from Hector Soto. Gord Perrin just had to get out of the way of that one before he got hurt. There's going to be a one-on-one situation here on the right side of the screen, and that one is down hard. Escalante hits the ball out of bounds. The Canadians making Puerto Rico work for everything now. But Morales continues to stymie them. But Morel is calling this ball out. He is saying that it touched the antenna. Nobody can believe it, but the Canadians will take it. Gaspar is incredulous. And Morel is going to call his down official over to confer. Oh, now maybe that did not go over. But you could see by the expression on Nick Hogue's face that he touched it. And so the right call is made, the ball to Puerto Rico. Schmidt off the block is dug. the block. Comes Soto. So Canada now a slim margin, a single point. The connection between Sanders and Schmidt not quite there today. But full credit to Puerto Rico, playing hard, digging everything the Canadians have to offer. Except that one out of the back row. Short serve. Punched off the block, and a net touch called on Graham Vigras. So some strong play from Mannix Roman. Responds. Canada clinging to a two-point margin so far. Nick Hogue at the end line has had all kinds of problems putting that ball over the net. We'll see if he can fix that problem. Take something off it. As this one is forced in the middle, terrific set. And Escalante just chops at it. See Escalante with the hands behind his head. Doesn't want to get hit by his server. Perrin is dug. Here comes Rivera. But the block is there. As TJ Sanders and Vigras hold tight together. It's a one-point ball game here in set number four. Puerto Rico is trying to make this go five. The Canadians want to finish it. And Rivera stretching out, but he can't get a piece of it as Verhoef's middle is successful. And the Canadians just having trouble breaking this one open as Soto goes with the roll. Canadians keep it alive and they have a chance here. And finally, Gavin Schmidt uses his length to advantage, puts that one down. So Puerto Rico calls a timeout on the play. As finally the Canadians have a little breathing room. It's only 3 points though, 16-13 at the technical timeout. The team's back on the floor as this match approaches 2 hours here. Canada and Puerto Rico are engaged in a mighty battle here as Goas finishes that one after Morales' dig came over the net. The Canadians up by two, trying to close out Puerto Rico. Escalante has a good spin serve. Has to take something off this one though. Poor toss. Schmidt goes deep and this one is in for the Canadians. He's fired up. Here comes Morales, he's stopped. Here they come again though. In that middle. Mannix Roman so effective in transition. He's quick on his feet, fast arm swing. Nick Hogue is stuffed on a one-on-one situation by Morales, and the Canadians have called a timeout as Puerto Rico is making a move here. The gap now a single point. Puerto Rico and Canada engaged in a battle here in pool play action. The Canadians out quickly, won the first two, but Puerto Rico has come storming back and they are trying to win this fourth set to stay alive. But Verhoef wipes that one off the block. The team Canada maintains a 2-point advantage, but Puerto Rico's defense has been stellar. Finally, Soto makes an error on that hit. He tried to turn it down the line. Could this be the gap the Canadians need? Here they come from the wing. And that one is down. Morales over Gavin Schmidt. Morales, only 23 years of age. That's his 31st attack of this match. Easy pass for the Canadians. Here they come in the middle. So Canada gets to 21st, the game to 25. Gavin Schmidt on the end line, 2017, Canada over Puerto Rico. Set number four. Canadians won the first two. Puerto Rico fought back in set number three. And it has been close all the way here in set number four. Gavin Schmidt taking something off that serve, keeping it in. Here's a chance for the Canadians to the wing and Hogue. But Escalante's coming in, a save again. And Hogue blasts this one out of bounds. A wasted opportunity for Team Canada. But there's that pursuit from Puerto Rico. Here comes Roman from the service line. Easy pass there. And there's the pipe. That one has scored every single time. Great disguise by Gord Perrin. Using the big body of Vigras as the screen. Hogue puts a tough one in. Morales off the block. And it is down. And this Puerto Rican side is patient, just siding out back and forth, waiting for the opportunity. Morales scores the ace. That's the one he was looking for. It is off the outstretched arms of Nick Hogue. So much topspin and side spin. And the Canadians now call a timeout. It's a 1-point ball game here. Glenn Hogue scratching his head, wondering what he has to do here to help his team. Showing good distribution. Escalante with 11 hits. Morales 33. Soto 19. Rivera 20. So Goas doing a good job of keeping the blockers guessing on the Canadian side. And we have a substitution as Hogue is going to come out and Winters will come in. Canada leads in set four over Puerto Rico, trying to win this match in four sets. Puerto Rico fighting to stay alive, though. And some big serving there, as here comes the back row, and it's down. Gavin Schmidt puts it away. Incredible resilience from the Puerto Rican squad. They were buoyed by that win over the United States. Vigras puts this one in. It's an over bump, and it's down. Rudy Verhoef was right there. That was a big, big point for the Canadians as they have a bit of breathing room. And Puerto Rico takes a quick timeout. Fourth set action between Canada and Puerto Rico. A double substitution for the Canadians as Tone Van Lankveld comes into the front row. Dustin Schneider into the back row. The Canadians with a big wall up there looking to make contact with that ball. Get a block or a slowdown with a transition opportunity. Graham Vigras on the end line. Here comes Puerto Rico out of the back row, and it is an error by Hector Soto. Unfortunate for this Puerto Ricans who have played so well, but that creates a match point opportunity, and Puerto Rico will go to the bench. Cruz coming in along with Perez, and out comes Morales and Goas. Two athletes who have played so well. Canada, though, looking to close this match out, pick up the 4 points. Set to the middle. Kept alive by the Puerto Ricans. It's tight. The block is there. Tone Van Lankveld and Rudy Verhoef shut the door on Puerto Rico. Canada wins. Well, there was some chirping at the net between these two teams, but there are handshakes as the teams leave the court here. The Canadians with a very hard fought 3-1 victory over Puerto Rico. This ball a little bit tight to the net, and the block rock solid for Canada. So the Canadians win 3-1, and they move to the top of Pool B. They'll be looking to win that pool in their next match, but for today, they savor the victory. And those are the stats. Not much between these two teams. More digs from this Puerto Rican squad. The Canadians making a slew of serving errors, 20 in fact, which kept Puerto Rico in the match. But for Canada, they move to the top of the pool standings with 9 points. More importantly, 2 wins. 1-1 for Puerto Rico, and the U.S. and Mexico still winless.